Go!
This is like, there's a game called Karate Champ, and they had like the judge, see, and, like, the judge was there, so I think that what they're doing is some sort of Karate Champ.
They're really hurting her. I feel very uncomfortable.
This guy.
Who's that guy?
I'm looking at you.
Can you shut up?
You guys are going to a movie. How come I didn't know about you guys going to a movie? I want to go to a movie.
This is Jace's idea, and obviously he wants to only see half the movie.
I just want to know, because I've been a fan of yours for a long time. This man is amazing.
Why are we filming this?
Because we got picked up for season 5 of the Jace Hall show, and I don't have a lot of content, so I'm a little light, and you're Rick Fox.
With IGN?
They actually picked us up, gave us a budget that allowed us to buy these very expensive 3D cameras instead of hiring more staff.
Wow, that's 3D?
Yeah, 3D. I hope you don't mind the cameras.
Wow, that's kind of cool.
You okay? You want me to get your coffee?
Yeah.
So tell me about this Defiance game. Because I keep wanting to say Defiant, which is the spaceship from Voyager. Is it all platforms that you cover?
Well, we had Rift, which came out on the PC. Defiance, which we're going to show you today, is PC, Xbox, and PS3.
Three different platforms simultaneously with an MMO.
Yeah. It's one of the first real transmedia experiences that's been developed for both a TV show and game. We're working with the Sci-Fi Channel. They're building a television show, and we're building a game based in the exact same universe that occur at the exact same time, and there's crossover that happens between both.
Is there sort of like a source Bible that both of the things are being derived from?
Yeah, absolutely. We built the Bible here, down here in the San Diego office, and handed it off to Sci-Fi.
But you're not telling the same story exactly, right?
We're not telling the same story.
It's like if you're watching the TV program, you're gonna get more if you also are playing the game.
It's the same universe with the same species and technology, and we will have things that happen in the game that will then all of a sudden appear in the television show. And things that happen in the television show will all of a sudden appear in the game, usually right away.
So what are you guys doing like on the story for this game?
Well, the backstory is about a group of alien races that live in this single solar system, and they learn early on that their solar system's gonna be destroyed. Only place that they find that they can go is Earth. They asked if they can colonize. People don't like being displaced. But the humans are interested in the technology, so they allow this stuff to start happening. Governments are destroyed, you know, landscapes are destroyed, whole civilizations are destroyed. The players come in as a mercenary within that world.
It's not a Star Trek game.
It is not a Star Trek game. It is a science fiction game, but no, it's not Star Trek.
Okay.
You guys really have to be
honest. You're a very attractive woman. This is not good.
Help her.
Help her.
I'm not going out.
Listen, I have a medical kit. I can help.
I have a band-aid.
Your face is menstruating.
Susan Carter!
No, you have to be quiet. Be quiet, okay?
Jason will come out there.
So he's not, you're just saying, basically you're saying he's not pulling his weight.
No, he's off doing other things like Space 2099 and the morning after show.
I'm gonna have to shave my head, right? I think that's actually one of the big reasons why.
I think part of the reason why we don't attract a younger crowd is because Jason is bald. Your hair, I just want to get in there, you know, and rub my hands around
it. It's called a moneymaker. The hosting game is called a moneymaker. Like, that's why I get hired.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I got a moneymaker. I got hair, I got, you know, yeah. The teeth, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, look at the face, right?
Yeah, look at the
face. See, like in 3D, you can see the face, right? So I'm talking about now think of his face and my face. Do you see what I'm saying, Todd?
What? This is your wife?
My sister.
Ma perché noi siamo qui? Chi è questo uomo?
What is she speaking?
Italian.
Does she speak any English?
She was living in Italy for 4 years, so.
So she forgot her English skills?
Yeah, a little bit.
Ma guarda questi vestiti.
I don't have any STD. Can you communicate that? I know she's your sister.
When I host stuff, I look like a host. Why is he wearing t-shirts all the time?
Because t-shirts are cool.
Yeah, on some people.
Ball sack.
Just hit the fucking ball. Get to the ball.
Itch. Ni. San.
Sorry.
Seriously.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
I hate you.
How long have you guys been working on it since the first concept of it?
Well over 3.5 years.
What's been sort of the biggest challenge?
You know what, Jace, let me tell you. I mean, it's the marketing.
The marketing people.
Yeah, I mean, we got this guy, Alex. I mean, we're shipping on 3 platforms already, right? And he comes in and he's like, could you do it for iPad?
Are you serious?
Yeah.
That must create a lot of, like, conflict if you're getting, because they don't care if it'll take you, you know, 10 more years to add that feature.
But we just kind of go, yeah.
Just kind of brush them off and...
Yeah, whatever.
Okay, we got it. It's a shooter. Thousands of people can play. It's an MMO. I'm assuming there's persistence in your accomplishment achievements.
Yeah, you have a central character. I mean, you can have multiple characters, but there's a central character that you're developing. And being able to run across people in the world that you don't know and instantly group up with them and go off and do missions and add them to your friends list, all those kind of things are something that the shooter game space really doesn't have.
But as you play the game and then you eventually finish it, then...
Oh, there's no finishing this game. It's a massively multiplayer game. We're gonna be adding things over time.
Yeah, but you finish and you have the final answer.
Nope, this game is meant to go on for a long, long time.
Yeah, but that's if you're a noob. No game is unfinishable. I can finish the unfinishable. Let me play.
Okay.
Really? You're gonna let me play?
No.
Right.
Experts theorize the Titanic was sunk due to the added weight of the time travelers sent to warn the captain about the iceberg.
Okay, so what's happening here?
Well, you can see I'm playing with a bunch of other guys. You can see the other mercenaries there. We're basically just rolling into this mine, killing some cyborg miners, using all sorts of different weapons and different tactics,
Looking
off of each other.
How am I supposed to demonstrate to you what the true skill is? Because I'm telling you I can finish this game.
You're seeing it right here.
No, seriously, if you could just let me... If I were to get the controller, I would show you the ending of the game.
Don't you understand the game doesn't end?
It doesn't end because noobs like you play it. You've worked on this game for 3 years. Don't you want to see what the ending looks like? Look, there's a bug. Okay, come on, dude, there's a bug. I'm seeing a whole bunch of fun, and I'm seeing me not having it. I'm seeing you having it, and I'm seeing me not having it. So I was wondering if we could remedy that situation since I'm not here all the time. Give me like 2 minutes.
Nope.
And I'll finish the game.
There's no finishing the game.
I can finish an MMO. That's how epic the skills are. What weapon are you using? What is that?
This is called a BMG. It basically is a heal gun and it also damages multiple enemies.
Can I try it? Let me try that.
Nope. You know what? All this bug killing is making me kind of hungry. How about you? I'm gonna give you something to eat.
Where are you going?
Earthworms are hermaphrodites, so you can tell a worm to go f*** himself if you just look at you.
Crackerjack.
I was thinking I could actually play
cheese and crackers, some granola bars.
The game. No, no, I don't.
Noodles,
you were the one that
chips,
said you were hungry.
Oatmeal.
You were the.
Sorry.
You, whoa.
Sorry,
we were shooting. What are we doing?
Can you hand me one of those?
Who are you?
Jace, this is Alex from marketing.
Yeah. I had this awesome idea. Kill tweets. Every time you shoot someone, it sends a tweet out. All your friends know that you're killing them. You're killing your friends. And I would need it a month early so we can do promos for it. Kill tweets.
See what I mean?
Also, jetpacks.
He's my boy and all, but when you put friendship on the shelf, the show could go to another level. I could take the show to another level.
I'll find a way to put you into the show, and that way it can just... Oh, hey!
What's up? What's going on, Rick?
No, man. Just checking out the cameras.
Checking out the cameras when we're filming. Todd, what are you doing?
No, no, hey, Jeanene's in town.
This is his sister. She doesn't speak any English.
How are you?
No, she speaks English. That's how they do it.
Who's your friend?
He's nobody.
Oh, I thought so.
Why are you filming?
I can't, I don't.
What are you doing?
You got a fifth season, man.
Yeah, I did.
That's cool, man. Let's go check this movie out, man. Hey, Todd, good to see you, bro.
Later.
I don't know, man.
3D
hey guys, cameras. Nice meeting you guys, man.
Nice to meet you. Guys.
We're just showing the cameras.
No, you're not just. You did something.
She spoke English.
I'm not fooled.
Yeah, it's Rick Fox. See, already they're excited.
What are you doing?
What are you doing here? You shouldn't even be here.
Oh, you gotta be formal. This is a wedding. This is a special
He's
occasion.
Kidding.
I hired you for security, Jace. You're here to bounce.
Can I just interrupt and say that, you know, we've done a lot of interviews in our time, but this has gotta be one of the best.
We can cut that part out, right? That doesn't.
No, I love that part.
It's awesome.